Svitayo Svitka Pranamami Mahur Muhu Namasri Adirajaya Vivekananda Suraye Satchit Sukhasvarupaya Swami Meta Paharine. So see, we are living with a very interesting and important topic. What was Sri Ramakrishna's relationship with his own gurus? Why this is very important? See, Sri Ramakrishna himself, by that time, a few years after his sadhana, he himself was actually a guru, and he was initiating others. He was showing people the way to spiritual evolution, liberation, etc. So in that context, what was his relation? Normally, you know, this is a very special kind of a study. In fact, even in the case of probably, you know, the other avatars, even if you take, for example, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Ramakrishna, too, we have practically hardly any mention about the other gurus. Even if you say, take the case of Jesus Christ, John the Baptist came, he baptized him, but then that was the end of the matter. So you see, practically I cannot recall even in the other incarnations where this type of study or this angle of the life has been explored at all. You show any other example. See, in the case of Jesus, he came and baptized and he was reduced to a non-entity. John the Baptist became virtually Jesus' disciple from day one, so to say. Even if you take the case of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that Keshav Bharati, under whom he had in his sannyas diksha, afterwards practically no mention. And even the others, he had that Ishwar Puri's disciple Madhavendra Puri, he gave him the first Krishna mantra there in Jagannath Kshetra. Afterwards, their relationship, Madhavendra Puri was himself a great evolved soul, no doubt. But the relationship between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and this, how it was, you know, it was a fulfillment of a different nature altogether. You see, what this is something very extraordinary. See, you know, why this is very extraordinary, for example, if you take the case of Bhairavi Brahmani, Sri Ramakrishna learned so much under her guidance. Virtually, she was not like the other gurus in the other incarnations or other extraordinary souls' lives, where they gave just a little mantra, something, a very brief contact, and then the person was, you know, launched into such a state of spiritual evolution that there was no need for any guru. It was just a kind of a trigger. But samay ke liye, there was nothing very great about their contribution, as if they were just waiting for the ignition, just that much. That was all this spoken about, of all those cases. Whereas in the case of Sri Ramakrishna, first of all, it was a much greater contact. Even Bhairavi Brahmani stayed something like 5 or 6 years with him. And you know, step by step, all those 64 tantras, every minute bit, even the most difficult part of it, she made him go through everything. Similarly, if you take the case of Tothapuri. Tothapuri was a person, you know, Sri Ramakrishna, if you go by the life description or whatever you hear about Sri Ramakrishna's Leela and all that, from his boyhood, actually, wo kuch jante nahi the advait kya hai. That was the condition, virtually. Absolutely, he had no awareness of that kind of a sadhana at all. Will you do Vedanta sadhana? Hey, catch this. That was the kind of starting to begin with. But then, so at every minutest level, the guru had to guide Sri Ramakrishna, so to say. Because he was not even able to concentrate. She is not allowing me to be. Whenever I try to concentrate, that enchanting form comes and I am done. Finished. I can't do it. Let me give up. Kya? Nahi hoga. Hona chahiye. Simply you took a piece of glass and pierced the place between his eyebrows and then yahan tum man laga. You concentrate here. And then he goes into samadhi. Not only that, then, so you see, in his case also, the reverse happens. The guru being completely overwhelmed by his own depth of spiritual realization. That happened. Sri Ramakrishna, he kya aschajya, main saal, 40 saal se jo nahi kar paya. What I could hardly achieve in 40 years, this man in 3 days, impossible to bring him back to normal consciousness. Yet he was virtually lost to the world. He had to chant Om 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 continuously, and with great difficulty he brought his mind down to the level of the earthly existence. Not only that, later on, 6 months he was continuously immersed in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So although in this case also there is a kind of a initial initiation that sets about, that triggers a tremendous spiritual upsurge in Sri Ramakrishna, there is also the other aspect that they stay back to learn from each one. That's why that is the beauty of Sri Ramakrishna's life, his leela. Each and every person, whether he was a guru or a disciple or an ordinary person or anyone who comes into little closer contact with Sri Ramakrishna gets a completely fulfilling influence. So by the way, Brahmani, we will see as we go ahead how, although she was guiding him, slowly over the years, because of her staying there, people came to know more and more about her nature, what she was, what was the problem with her. Slowly the way she was reacting, the way she was getting angry, the way she was feeling jealous. So all those things, you know, completely they are revealed slowly. And then slowly Sri Ramakrishna shows him what is the way for fulfillment. So the fulfilling aspect of Sri Ramakrishna's life is something which is very extraordinary. So this Bhairavi Brahmani also, as years went by, people came to know about her own shortcomings. And when she finally realized that she needed to evolve, and then she really learned from Sri Ramakrishna and went away to Varanasi to do intense sadhana. So you know, we also know in the case of Tothapuri, although he was a great Brahmagyani, he was not accepting the immanent aspect, the manifestation aspect of the Supreme Self. How the highest reality, Brahman, is all pervasive in and through all existence. Actually, you know, that is one of the outstanding contributions of this Ramakrishna Vivekananda tradition, because otherwise there was a clear divide. Once you transcend the normal limitations of the body, mind, etc., etc., as we go higher and higher, as we go towards the ultimate knowledge, the emphasis was always on negating the world, negating all existence, looking down upon everything as maya, are absolutely irrelevant. But Sri Ramakrishna gave a new meaning. It's not irrelevant, it is supremely relevant. If you can accept this and make it part of your life and your sadhana, you go to greater depths. You get a greater meaning, a greater motivation. Because otherwise, you see, in today's current context in the world as it is today, but for Sri Ramakrishna, people would have completely gone away from these traditions once and for all. Because, you know, 99% of us, the humanity, is so deeply engaged in activities connected with the world. How can you say that the world is illusory? How can you say the world is irrelevant? So Sri Ramakrishna gave a new twist, a new meaning to the whole thing. So that's why Tothapuri also, who was not belonging to this school, who had the older idea that the world is illusory, Brahman alone is satya, everything else is mithya, ekya devi maya, that's what he used to say. So the world is maya, absolutely a creation of the mind or some other, that kind of entity. And slowly, after that famous incident, which we will come to know about the terrific, unbearable stomach ache that resulted in his trying to give up the body, even that was not possible. However much, no, that is another great revelation. However much we detest his body, जितने भी आपकी पसंद नहीं है यू मस्ट लर्न फ्रॉम स्वतःप्री क्या आप पूर्ण ब्रह्म ज्ञानी थे शरीर प्रति बिल्कुल कोई उनकी आसक्ति नहीं था यू हैव नो अटैचमेंट व्हाट से यू आर रेडी टू गिव इट अप जस्ट लाइक ए यूज्ड गारमेंट एनी टाइम सच अ पर्सन हु हैड बीन कंप्लीटली एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन ब्रह्म ज्ञान फॉर 40 ईयर्स When he went to immerse himself, he found that there was not enough water in the Ganges. Should we not learn? कोई कोई मेरे आके कहते हैं हाँ मैं अभी चल जाना चाहता हूँ कहाँ जाओगे? Where will you go? Where is the place? You have to come back. Unless we have that knowledge, there is no going. And a person even with that full, no, that is the beauty. Even if you have that full knowledge, it's not possible to go away because there's something called prarabdha. Not only that, unless your life is complete, in one sense, even if you have Brahma Jnana, your knowledge is not complete. It is not Purna. That is where Sri Ramakrishna made him realize that even beyond Brahma Jnana, knowledge is the highest absolute. There is a way where you get fulfillment. That is where when you learn to accept that the manifest world also as part of that ultimate reality. As another shape, another room, another way of presenting, another way of expression of the highest reality. When you get it, then the life becomes completely fulfilled. So for that he had, so each one of those gurus had to learn from Sri Ramakrishna to make their life fulfilled. In fact, that was one of the reasons why they came. Not only to initiate or ignite the spiritual fire in him for a particular type of sadhana, at the same time, to get fulfilled themselves. In fact, Mr. Sadhmas also talks in detail about the three different schools of Tantra. In Tantra Sadhana also there are three. Oshu Bhav, and then the Divya Bhav, and then there is another. There are three Bhavas he talks about. So how although Bhairavi Brahma initiated Sri Ramakrishna into all the 64 the divisions or the subdivisions of Tantra, how he found that his bhava was so superior. That also we will come to see. Now we were talking about this Chandra and Girija. Because Bhairavi Brahmani was supposed to meet three sadhakas in her life. Two she had already met, namely Chandra and Girija. She had also given them some guidance. She was very sincerely searching for the third person. And finally she got Sri Ramakrishna. So when she saw him, जब भी मुलाकात हुआ आश्चर्य जो है मैं तो आपके लिए कितना ढूंढ रहा आई एम सर्चिंग सो मच फॉर यू बिकॉज यू आर द थर्ड पर्सन हुम आई न्यू थ्रू अ विजन दैट आई हैव टू गाइड इन दिस लाइफ सो वो जानते थे उनकी काम पूर्ण हो जाएगा जब ठाकुर के कुछ दे देंगे शिक्षा बस उनकी काम खत्म सो एंड इंसिडेंटली हियर ठाकुर ऑल्सो टॉक्स अबाउट the idea of Chandra and Girija. Not only that, but even if you read the life of Chandra, the little description that you get of Chandra and Girija, through this, the discussion on Sri Ramakrishna's relationship with gurus and the incidents that Sri Ramakrishna mentions, although he does not directly state, this idea also comes to our mind that even if you go to a person like Bhairavi Brahma, still their life was not complete. See, they had, according to a divine mission, she was to help three people. Two she had already helped, but that was not sufficient. Once a gir pade udono, she had taken them, she had given them some hints. They were found to have great spiritual powers and a thrust for sadhana. But how they fell from their state of glory and how they were really in a sorry state, and how by coming into contact with Sri Ramakrishna, there again the spiritual fervor, the drift for deep sadhana was again kindled, and how they really progressed, that also we will get. So you see, the point is, that is why we have to be very extremely alert in that sense. Sri Ramakrishna also again says, the guru, the concept of guru, that is too important. Unless, see, can you imagine a person like Bhairavi Brahmani, if you had come to such a guru and if you had done sadhana, you should get the highest. Where is the question of coming down? So even if you go to such a guru, unless you are extremely alert yourself, that is one thing. And then unless you are directly under the protecting power of an avatara, it is not possible to reach the ultimate goal in spiritual life. So Bhairavi Brahmani could not lead them to the ultimate level of knowledge because that was even beyond him. Only an avatara can directly ensure that you go and reach the highest level of mukti. That is one thing. And secondly, even in spiritual life, the pitfalls, the dangers that are lurking, that is something which one should be aware of. Only for that purpose, Maharaj Saradananda has little more details about the life of Chandra and Girija is furnished here. So that's why Sri Ramakrishna used to say, Sachidananda, your own, the inner pure self, that alone is the real guru or the ultimate guru. And also there is always that cow there, even if you get the blessings is everything, aapki khud, your own blessings, your own mind, body, that they don't do favor, you cannot do sadhana. That's why, you know, Nitsa also for that matter, even though there are many who were initiated by mother, many were not doing anything at all, even one person even wrote so much, tum vapas le jao, mera jurvat nahi hai, kya diya tum mere ko, I have got nothing to take it back. Even to that extent people have gone, but mother did not lose heart, or she didn't turn them away. She said, nahi, tumko kuch karna jurvat nahi, you don't have to do anything, you be as you are, jo marni karo na, main dekh lunga. Finally, day and night, 1 lakh japa, she had to do for everybody else, so that they would really get something and they would not be at least guilty of the violations of disobeying the guru's diction. So here, you know, in the case of Chandra, he says, here because of his contemplative nature and his power of sadhana, that's what they say. Of course, in the Yoga Sutra, there are very detailed discussions about anima and agima and all that, the powers that a sadhaka gets if a person is a very serious aspirant. So here one siddhi called gutika siddhi. So after sanctifying a gutika, like a ball, a small ball, if you would chant some mantras and if he holds it under his arm, he can go in any place without people noticing him. Koi nahi dekh paata tha usko. Bahut, wherever he wanted, even the most secure place, bahut vivastha hai. वहां भी अंदर चल जाते थे. ही कुड गो देयर ऑल्सो विदाउट एनी बडी सीइंग. नाउ यू सी रियली यू नो दैट इज वेयर मीन द डिस्ट्रैक्शंस इन स्पिरिचुअल लाइफ कैन कम इन एवर सो मेनी वेज. व्हाट इज द पॉइंट, व्हाट इज द यूज फॉर अ साधक, ए पर्सन हु इज इंटरेस्टेड इन गॉड एंड इन अल्टीमेट रियलिटी, व्हाट इज द नीड फॉर हिम टू गो सीक्रेटली टू एनी प्लेस, व्हाट इज द यूज, क्या जरूरत बताइए, बिना किसी को बोल के कहां अंदर जाना क्या जरूरत है. फॉर ए पर्सन इज इंटरेस्ट इन घाट, दैट इज माया, दैट इज हाउ इट कम्स एंड कवर्स ऑल द नॉलेज दैट यू हैव. इवन इफ यू एनालाइज अवर ओन लाइफ, यू फाइंड लेटर ऑन आफ्टर एनी इंसिडेंट, अरे क्या जरूरत है, मैं क्यों किया, जस्ट वी डोंट गेट द आंसर एट ऑल. अरे मैं इतना समझता हूं, आई नो सो मच, आई हैव अंडरस्टूड सो मच, आई हैव टॉक्ड, आई हैव डिस्कस्ड, आई हैव स्टडीड, आई हैव थॉट अबाउट, फिर भी मैं ऐसा किया. That is called the deluding power of Maya, Mohini Shakti. So you would go like that. If a person achieves occult powers before realizing God, he or she becomes egoistic. That is the problem. Yahi Shakti se, unhone sochne laga, main bahut shaktiman, I am a very powerful person. That is the kind of distraction that these type of powers bring about. He became egoistic, thinking that this is a very big power I have got. Main sabse zyada se zyada mera taakat hai. So what he would do, the enhancement of the ego traps the aspirant in a net of desires, preventing any further movement towards higher spiritual ideal. It finally becomes the cause of his or her downfall. So but when such a thing happens, at that time only all the other negative ideas start coming in. They are all waiting. Thakur kehte hai na ki ganga snan karne ke liye ja rahe hain sab, ped mein sab apeksha kar rahe hain. So now because this person has got something, all the other negative things which he had kept away, which he had somehow put aside because of his power of sadhana, because of his one-pointed devotion towards God or the truth, now they know this is the time to enter. So they come. They come and enter his mind in ever so many ways. They try to give him the wrong kind of blessing. Hey, main to kuch nahi dekh pa raha, nobody can see me. See, all of us are good because everybody is watching us. Supposing nobody watches us, we will also do things. So, like if a person gets that kind of a power, that nobody can see him. But, O Samajya me, jo marji kar sakta. See, how we know, there is a very famous Puranic, it's not exactly Purana, what do you call it? It's a very famous story, the story of Nala and Damayanti. How this man was so much devoted to truth. So, Edino, Kampus Gyata, Padhunik Samay, when washing the feet, he did not pour water on the heels. Only on the front portion he poured water. That small spot which he left, this Shani caught hold of him, and that started completely moving his life. How he lost everything, his kingdom, his wife, his son, and so many things. That's a big story. So like that, you know, the negative power, they just wait for a small little opportunity to sneak in. And in how many ways did the master explain to us? As the ego grows, so does sin. When the ego shrinks, one attains virtue. Because of the, if you also think that the people, the way we behave now on the outside, kaun karta hai? Are, samajhte hai? Main kitna mera? I am so rich, so powerful, you don't know to whom you are talking. So, you find that, you know, that is why in samaj maybe, ordinary people, poor people, they do not commit so much of crimes. Only, aap dekhi ho, road rages mein kitna kitna aate. Only people going in very, very powerful, expensive cars and others, they alone commit most of these crimes, etc., etc. Kyo? Because money gives tremendous kind of an ego. The ego that yes, I am really powerful, I can buy anything. Jo marji mein kar sakta. You know, Thakur's life was a famous story. He was watching, somebody was, one Brahmana was sitting on the shore. He said, Are Thakur Mahashaya, ki khabar? He said, Are bhai, aur paisa hoye chale. He said, aur paisa hoye chale. Somebody had given him some small little coin, and this man had become so egoistic. You know, Sagar also used to say another beautiful story, a small frog, it got some poor anas or something. He said it was showing that it will give a lathi to a big elephant. Money is so powerful, you know. Even about mission also they crack a very nice joke, even about mission and our staff. So I can tell you privately, don't tell others. So what happens is, since Indra, they always say, you know, Purana, this story is always said, if some ko jaha bahut bade sahabat dekhte, to Indra ke dar lagta hai. Or, abhi aake mera gadi wo le lega. They are afraid that they may capture the kingdom of Indra. So, turat wo kuch vipatti pahuncha dete hai wahan. Immediately, you will send some herds. So, wo dekh rahe, pehle sahabi log barana kushti shuru karte, itna sadhan bajitnya tapasya mein lag gaye hain. Indra ko bahut dar laga, are bhai to mushkil hai, itna jab dhyan kar rahe, mera sab to jayega hi. Kya kya ho, upar akash se ek 5 rupiya coin leke fek diya tha. So tongue samte karke sab jameen mein gira, with the tongue sound it fell on the ground, immediately the sadhu's eyes opened. Jo nahi pehchanta tha kya hai, je haath mein utha diya, बस खत्म. उस दिन से सब जब ध्यान खत्म, दिन रात यही करो, वही करो, प्रोग्राम करो, सेलिब्रेशन करो, पैसा उठाओ, वैल्यू एजुकेशन करो. बट ऑफकोर्स इज ओनली जोक, यू डोंट टेक इट सीरियसली. सो इज इट द मनी. इफ अ फ्रॉग कैन टेल एन एलिफेंट आई विल किक यू, सो यू कैन इमेजिन हाउ मनी कैन कंप्लीटली डिल्यूड अवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. So, that is one of the manifestations of ego. See, ego comes in several ways, in the form of money. Money also, you know, even if you look at the, it's not money by itself. The idea of the power, the tremendous sense of strength that one feels, you know. Dhan bala, artha bala, the bala, the strength one feels because of money. The idea that I can capture anything, I can get anything under my thumb. So, the idea, so it not only through money, even this idea, this kind of a supernatural power, where he could enter any place without being seen by others, he thought that he can do anything. And that's what exactly he didn't got into trouble. The increase of egoism destroys spirituality. All trouble cease when the eye dies, that's why Thakur used to say, Ami molle guchibe janja. When the ego dies, then one. So, he said further, see, because you know, ego, the moment you have this very strong ego, ultimately, you know, ultimately, whether it is a path of jnana, whether it is a bhakti, all these paths also, what ultimately happens, in the case of the path of jnana, there is only the supreme consciousness or the supreme reality, Brahman or Atman, and there is neha nanasti keji, there is no duality, that is the condition. So even in the case of the highest kind of a bhakta, what happens? The bhakta goes deeper, 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 deeper into his worship or his adoration of the ishta or the devata. So much so completely his personality, his individuality, his I is completely obliterated, leaving only the presence of God. He does not feel his own presence, his own individuality, his own importance, his own very existence. That is the highest state of bhakti. So when there is ego, ego definitely always means duality. My ego. Ego is not a state of advaita. Ego is duality. The moment you, the stronger you feel ego, there is a clearer and clearer perception of duality. Duality is always dukkha. Duality always means destruction. Because you know, all the experiences that we have in this world, sukha, dukkha, anything comes because of this understanding or acceptance of the idea of duality. Whenever there is duality, there is dukkha, there is conflict, there is contradiction, there is inconsistency, incongruency. So, duality always brings all this. So, that is why in the bhakti also, even a bhakta, as long as he feels that he is different from God, there are problems, there are difficulties, there are fights, there are misunderstandings. But which you see even in bhakti schools, even amongst bhaktas, followers of this bhakta and that bhakta, Shakta was a Vaishnava, then Rama was a Krishna, so many kinds of, all those Kali was a Krishna, all the, why? Because there is this duality is there. He feels that I am there, my ishta is there, so as long as you recognize this duality, the problem exists. So when you go to such a level where you don't recognize duality at all, then anything, wherever you see, you will see only the same idea, the same manifestation of your own ishta in ever so many forms. That way you get rid of duality, and that is how you get rid of sukha, dukkha, sorrow, everything. So that is why, you know, in Sri Ramakrishna, you see, he is the Sarvadeva Devi Swarupa. That is the idea that we are also taught, that everywhere you should have this understanding only. And in Sri Ramakrishna's life also, he had so obliterated his own ego. There was nothing called ego in him. He was part of the cosmic mind itself. So wherever he saw, whichever ishta he saw, that was completely accepted. Because you see, whether it was the Shakta Sadhana, Vaishnava Sadhana, Tantra Sadhana, Vedanta Sadhana, any Sadhana, for him, it was only the same reality projected in ever so many ways. So there was no conflict, there was no that kind of a distinguishing kind of a duality in his understanding. That's why he was always steering clear of any kind of a conflict or difficulty. So when you develop this kind of a ego or a power or any capacity, you immediately develop very strongly the idea of duality. And there is always this conflict and constant difficulty and problem. See, look at how the scriptures describe the ego as chit jada granthi, a knot of consciousness and consciousness. Chit is consciousness, jada is inertness, chit jada granthi. When you bind these together, that is the ego. Because why? Essentially, you know, the idea of consciousness is also part of chitta, your own idea. Without that, you know, you will only be jada. So the awareness is also there. But that awareness is constantly being clouded, being affected, being conditioned by the idea of jada or the inertness. So you bind these two together. Chav, dhuta, mishe, akakar hoye, chit jada granti hoye. In that knot which is full of all kinds of complications, to sort it out is the idea of sadhana, where you, when they become separate, then the jada automatically goes beside, chitta alone remains. Chit means the Atman, which is consciousness itself. Jada means matter, such as body, senses and so on. Tying these together, this ego has created firm division in the human mind. I am a jiva endowed with body, senses, intellect and so on. One cannot make any progress without cutting this terrible knot. Vidyate hridaye granthi siddhyante sarvasamshaya. That what they say in the Upanishad, the knots of doubt and the samshaya in the heart are completely cut asunder by that knowledge, that supreme knowledge. When it dawns, these knots are automatically untied or they are cut asunder. The Divine Mother has shown me that occult powers are to be shunned like excrement. One should pay no attention to them. Sometimes they arise of themselves. When you practice sadhana, but you take notice of them, you will be caught, you won't be able to reach God. So Sri Ramakrishna was extremely careful. Again and again you see they are like a human waste. You should never even look at them. You would use such powerful language. So that you know, the moment something, this is also another his way of teaching. Whenever you say something which is extremely despicable, something which people will hate from their heart, then you will, whenever that happens, immediately you are alert. Arey, to itna ganda hai. Isme chona nahi hai. Sparsh karna nahi. In fact, he also says, in fact, to each one of his disciples, he will often say, when even when he came to know that Niranjan was doing this placer, he scolded him, warned him, never do that. Booth karke tum booth ho jaoge. You will become a spirit if you keep on doing all. Never indulge in that. Not only that, you know, when Swamiji, after the experience, when he touched Abhidharaji, Thakur was very critical. Bahut kuch aisa kuch vyavahar kiye shabd you have, something like abhashan you have done. You was progressing a particular line, you have completely brought about a disaster. Anyway, not too much damage is done, but please never again do it. Not with the hearing. Sadma talks of another aspect of Swamiji, which it's not much known. When he was doing very serious sadhana, meditation, it seems he was extremely alert, and then he suddenly found that even though he was indulging in, you know, like normal activities, his mind was constantly focused on the highest or the Supreme God. So, he is perfect in meditation. Dhyan Siddha Swamiji Samadhi Kadhate. So suddenly he found that while meditating, Swamiji found that he had developed powers of clairvoyance and clairaudience. He could simply see what was happening at a long distance, and not only that, he could hear also what was being discussed. So, few times what he did was, he immediately got up from his feet to go and verify what he saw and what he heard was correct. दो तीन बार वो आसन छोड़ के चले गए थे देखने के लिए क्या मैं ठीक दिख रहा हूँ ठीक सुन रहा हूँ. He went and saw and then after a few times then he confessed to Sri Ramakrishna. पहले क्या सच किया देख लूँगा फिर बाद में बताऊँगा. And then he reported it to the master. So immediately he said, these powers are obstacle to the path of God realization. ऐसा तुम्हारी भगवान की सान्निध्य पाने का भगवान लाभ का पथ में ऐसा विपत्ति है. डोंट सिंपली शंदम डोंट गो एनीवेयर नियर नॉट विद देयर ही सेड डोंट मेडिटेट फॉर अ फ्यू डेज. इतना तक कह दिया डोंट मेडिटेट अनलेस यू गेट ओवर दैट कंडीशन डोंट इवन डू मेडिटेशन सिंपली यू कीप क्वाइट डोंट डू इट. सो नॉट विद दैट दैट्स व्हाई दे से यू नो मीन इवन वेरी सीरियस साधना अनलेस वन इज रियली प्रिपेयर्ड it's not really good to go into very intense mode of sadhana. That's why we never mission also they never ask you to do something extreme. Nahi chalte chalte karo ek baar baitho to theek hai 108 ginti kar lo kisi tarah ho jayega because they know that most of people are not really prepared. So without preparation if you try to do very intense type of sadhana it of course in the case of Swamiji brought about siddhi it can bring about difficulties in the case of others. Not that even we also know how a person like Virajanji also suffered. Not that he was not prepared, he was fully prepared, but then the method was slightly wrong. Even a person like Virajanji, mother said, Nene Baba, He said, he went everywhere for solution. Nobody could tell him. Finally, they sent him to mother. He was unbearable headache. He tried everything, every medicine, every patte, everything. Finally, mother said, simply straight away asked him, kahan dhyan kar, where do you meditate? Ma, main to sahasrar mein kar raha hu. Are, kya kiya tum? What did you do? My child, never do it. Do it in your heart. Actually, they say our classical, our traditional idea, the thing is, Guru is to be the highest manifestation of Brahman is in the sahasrara, thousand petal lotus. So that is the seat of the even Satchidananda, the Guru, that sense. But mother said, no, you should not do it unless you are extremely well prepared. See, what happens, you know, if you do such thing without, with not much of intensity, no harm will come. आप यहाँ भी ध्यान करो, यहाँ भी ध्यान करो, ध्यान ही में नहीं मन नहीं बैठता है, क्या पैदा क्या है, यहाँ भी करो ना, दूसरी किसी को हृदय में भी करो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. सो दैट फॉर एज नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल, बिकॉज नो वेर एवर यू मेडिटेट द माइंड इज एनी वे इज नॉट गेटिंग कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड, वॉट इज द प्रॉब्लम. बट इफ यू हैव अ रियली पावरफुल माइंड विच इज केपेबल ऑफ इंटेंस कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, अनलेस इट इज डन अकॉर्डिंग टू द बेस्ट पॉसिबल बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस आर द मोस्ट act in the real way of doing it, then what happens, you know, it can bring about complications, like as it did in the case of Virajananda. So, Thakur was very clear, he said, you don't meditate for some time, you just stay away from meditation. So, Chandra's ego became inflated after he achieved this Guttika Siddhi. The master told us that Chandra gradually became infatuated with the daughter of a respected wealthy man, and began to visit her using his miraculous powers of invisibility. इसी को लड़की के साथ के परिचय हो गया, का देखने के लिए गुटी का सिद्धि लेके चुपचाप चल जाता था, किसी नहीं देख पाता. लेकिन as his egoism and selfishness increased, Chandra lost his occult power and was humiliated. कुछ दिन के बाद आप मन दूसरी जगह जब जाएगा, वैसे ही आपके साधन की भी गति भी कम हो जाए. इट विल नॉट बी दैट पावरफुल. सी ही हैड दैट पावर बिकॉज ही वॉज एन इंटेंस साधक. द मोमेंट हिज माइंड गॉट अट्रैक्टेड टू समथिंग एल्स, ऑब्वियसली ही वॉज नॉट डिवोटिंग सो मच टाइम टू साधना, एंड द साधना गोज डाउन, द सिद्धि ऑल्सो गोज डाउन, एंड ही कुड नो लॉन्गर डू, एंड ही वेंट दे फाउंड आउट दिस फेलो हैज कम, दे मस्ट हैव थ्रैश्ड हिम एंड थ्रोन हिम आउट. सो दैट इज हाउ ही वॉज ह्यूमिलिएटेड. बट यू नो द प्रॉब्लम इज लेटर ऑन. Because he came into contact with Ramakrishna, somebody mentions that Chandra really got back the impetus to do intense sadhana. That is where Ramakrishna's the power of fulfillment comes. He again got back because there is something that is given about Chandra's later life. In 1899, when Swamiji went to England and America for the second time, he came back. And after this, a person came and introduced himself as Chandra to Belur Math, and he lived for in the mud for about a month or so. So Brahman used to talk to him very intimately, and he would repeatedly ask, Chandra would ask Brahmananji, do you really feel the loving presence of the master here? Kya anubhav kar rahe ho Brahman ka? Because he would go to the temple, he would simply continuously shed tears. He would address Ramakrishna as Dada. And you know, he was in such a condition, he used to spend long hours in japa and meditation in the shrine, with tears running down his face. If anyone asked him about the master, he would joyfully relate whatever he knew. He appeared to be a quiet man. So you see, they found that here was a person about whom they had heard from the master, indulging in such intense, serious sadhana. So it seems, he said, whatever Ramakrishna had predicted about me, everything has come true. Only one thing is remaining. He said that I will appear before you at the time of death. उन्होंने कि कहा था मैं सचमुच आके तुम्हारे साथ उस समय I'll meet you at the time I'll give you darshan. So he said that was the only thing that he was looking forward. He said, whatever and addressed the master. Their understanding was, see, after their meeting Sri Ramakrishna, their understanding was awakened and they moved. He continued to address the picture of Sri Ramakrishna as the elder brother and then profusely shed tears of love and devotion. He looked like an ordinary man of sada, simple, used to wear cloth, etc. Then finally he said that he often travelled to various places. Chandra agreed and he would come and stay, but he never finally came back to Bellu. Probably he died. But he said, whatever the master predicted about him, everything has been fulfilled, excepting one, that the master promised to appear before him at the time of his death. So, this is a case where he was completely fulfilled by coming into contact with master. Now, the other person, his name was Girija. This Girija was also like that. He was also a great sadhaka. One day the master walked with Girija to Shambhumalik garden house near Dakshineswar. Then they were talking for a long time about spiritual matters. So samay to bahut bit gaya. Sri Ramakrishna kuch uske bare mein pata nahi tha. He did not realize. He was in a completely God intoxicated. But then the bahar aaya, simply, you know, he found that he was not able to find his way to the Dakshineswar, his own room. So he was struggling. Actually, Chandra was holding his hand. Then he suddenly said that, you don't worry, I will give you light. He asked him to go. Chandra simply turned back, and from his back, there was Girija. There was a big kind of like a focused light just coming from his back. It lighted up the entire pathway and Sri Ramakrishna could easily reach his place. So he had this occult power. So see, of course here he has mentioned about Shambhu Malik's devotion to Thakur and how he was Thakur's Asiddhar and so on. But finally this is the idea. Similarly, he stumbled at every step because he had left Shambhu's garden in a God-inducted state. He had not noticed this darkness. But when Girija noticed this, he stopped and said, wait a bit, brother, I will give you light. He then turned around and projected a beam of light from his back, illuminating the road. The master told us, with that light, I clearly saw the way up to the gate of the Kali temple and reached it without difficulty. The master then smiled and flamboyed his narration, but they did not retain those occult powers. Why Siddhi Sarpan looked past? Nehira. Kya hua? When they lived with me, their powers disappeared. When we asked the reason for this, the master said, the Divine Mother withdrew those powers into this. Afterward, they gave up supernatural practices and resumed their progress along the path towards God. So Sri Ramakrishna, you know, has to say, the one mission of his life was to encourage sadhakas, to show people the right path. So when this Chandra and Girija came with all those things, he slowly attracted them and then won over, and all those siddhis got merged into Sri Ramakrishna. And once those obstacles were removed in their life, once again they became great sadhakas and slowly reached the goal. And then, you know, another beautiful story also Sri Ramakrishna used to say, what is there in occult powers? When one's mind is entangled with them, one moves away from Sachidananda. Listen to this story. A man had two sons, ki do ladka thi. Bada ladka became a monk when he was young and he left home. Chota ladka to sadhi padhi kiya, sansar kiya, he was well established. बहुत साल के बाद, 10-12 साल के बाद बड़ा लड़का घर वापस आया. He came to see it maybe. So naturally the younger brother saw his elder brother, he was so joyous and happy and this is बहुत खिलाया पिलाया. बाद में पूछा, क्या तुम इतने साल बाहर रहा, क्या किया तुम, what is it that you have achieved, you have been there for so many years. Then the brothers, the monk said, अच्छा तुम मेरे साथ आओ. दोनों आए and then he said, you have given up worldly pleasures and wandered as a monk. Please tell me, what have you gained by this? And then they reached the bank of the river. Then the elder brother said, watch. Then he crossed the river, walking on the water. So, reaching the other bank, he said, "Arey, tum dekha? Aja, aja." Then the younger brother paid half a penny to a boatman and crossed the river. So again, then he said, "Did you notice me cross the river on foot?" Smiling, the younger brother said, "Didn't you see me pay half a penny to cross the river? Is that all you have gained by performing austerities for 12 years? Your power is worth only half a penny." Itna shastram kiya, kya ye nauka ye nadi paar hone ke liye hai, to main itna kam paisa karke paar hue, kya kya tum? So as the monk listened to his brother's words, he was awakened and he focused his mind on God. So you know, shastra in many ways used to infuse in others, tell them again and again, don't get distracted in any way whatsoever. आप भगवान के पास जाना चाहते हैं तो सचमुच सब छोड़ फोड़ के एक सिद्धांत लेके विद एकाग्र मन से विद कंप्लीट फोकस्ड माइंड इफ यू ट्राई सी दि सिद्धीज एक्सेट्रा आर ऑल्सो ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ दिस देयर आर मेनी मिलियन अदर टाइप्स ऑफ दिस ऑर्डिनरी पीपल डोंट इवन गेट दिस इवन टू गेट दिस यू हैव टू गो टू ग्रेट लेवल ऑफ साधना अदरवाइज इवन दिस डोंट कम वी गेट ओनली स्लीप नॉर्मली That is what we easily get by doing japa. But to get even these powers, one has to work very hard. So he used to say that, be focused, never get distracted, and that is the only way you can reach the highest. Then we shall again resume the story of Bhairavi Brahmani's advent and stay with Sri Ramakrishna next time when we meet. Now we shall stop here. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. हरि ओम तत्सत् श्री रामकृष्णार्पणमस्तु